there are a number of juggling tricks that rely heavily on you being able to do two easily in one hand. And one of the first of these is called the machine, and that will lead directly onto the invisible string trick. It all relies on doing two in one hand. So juggling two balls in one hand can be done in a couple of different ways, more than a couple, but a couple of useful ones. The first is to, your arm is kind of going around in a circular motion, throwing balls towards the outside of the pattern, going around like this. And that's a way to learn to do it. The key to getting control two balls in one hand is to try and keep the elbow very tightly tucked in. Keep the elbow tucked right in and allow the hand to go down quite a long way at first. Well, as you get control, when you've got control you can kind of do what you want with your hand, but at the beginning you need the height and also therefore the kind of motion, whether you're going to be doing it straight up and down, which is the one we're going to be looking at most, or whether you're going round and round. So going round and round is a good way to learn how to do it. But really, the way that holds more benefits is going straight up and down like this. Once again, if you really tuck your elbow right into your side and allow your hand to go down each time you catch the ball, you'll be able to find that you can do this in a fairly relaxed way, and after a bit you can control the height. If you have it lower, it kind of looks more impressive when you add the other ball in. It's on the floor at the moment, but when I get it. So doing two like that. So the first trick is the machine trick, where the ball in the other hand is mimicking one of the two balls, or the outside ball on this side. First I'm going to do the inside one so you can see what I mean by mimicking. I'm just copying the up and down movement of this ball here as I go up and down. If I stop there, I can mimic the movement of the outside ball, which is the one over on this side here, mimicking that one. And when I've got used to doing that, I'm going to try and bring my hand over like this as the outside ball. I can't tell whether it's going up or down. Yeah, as it's going down, as this one's going down, this one is going across. So the one that lands in this hand gets thrown at a slight diagonal. I don't have slow motion, I'll just have to just watch it carefully. So here we go, I'm going to pass it over, and there's the diagonal throw as it gets passed over. There's the diagonal throw. Across, across, as it were. Across carrying and across throwing. Across carrying with the left and across throwing with the right. So that's that throw there, diagonal throw, to this hand here, which has come back over this way after dropping that ball down. Drop and bring across and catch. Boom, boom, boom. I quite like just holding it up there and being able to put it back again, which would be beneficial to learning. That one there, which is a continuous movement of the machine star trick or the crane. Okay, hope that's helpful.